In this video, we are going to talk about the concept of a general solution of a differential equation and how it compares to the concept of a particular solution of a differential equation. At the end, we'll use these ideas to solve an exercise. Let's start with the differential equation dy dt equals 2y as an example. It turns out that for this equation, the general solution is y equals ce to the 2t. We came up with this solution in an earlier video, but it's okay if you haven't watched that yet. What we want to do here is to understand what it means to say that this solution is the general solution. So far, we have a formula for the solution, which represents an algebraic perspective. To get a better handle on this, let's look next at a geometric perspective. In other words, let's look at the graph of the solution. To make the graph, we have to realize that the constant c could represent any real number, so we're going to get not just one curve, but instead infinitely many curves. We can start by picking one value of c, say c equals 1, and then we do just get one curve. In this case, y equals 1 times e to the 2t, or just e to the 2t. The graph of that function looks approximately like this. Next, we can choose a different value of c, say 2, and we get a different curve, which looks roughly like this. We can continue in this way, even choosing fractional or negative values of c, for instance, and each time we choose a different value, we'll get a different curve. Keeping that in mind, I'm just going to plot a bunch of different curves to give you a better sense of the larger picture. Okay, let's complete our understanding with a verbal description of the general solution. The essential idea is that a general solution is not just any family of solutions, but instead, it actually includes all possible solutions, and no functions that are not solutions. All right, we've discussed what it means to say that a solution is the general solution. Next, let's discuss what it means to say that a solution is a particular solution. To understand this, let's look at the same differential equation as before, dy dt equals 2y, and to get an example of a particular solution, we just choose one particular value of c. So the example we chose before, where c was equal to 1, was actually an example of a particular solution. In that case, we had the particular solution y equals e to the 2t. If we were to choose a different value of c, say c equals negative 1/3, we would get a different particular solution. Now, the graph of a particular solution is just a single curve, which, if c equals 1, would look approximately like that. In other words, a particular solution is just one individual solution whose graph is a single curve, which you might remember is called an integral curve. Okay, to wrap up this video, let's finish with a quick exercise where we actually find the general solution for a certain differential equation and then use that to determine the particular solution that satisfies a given condition. Through this example, we'll also see a connection between what we're learning now and what you learned in calculus. Here's the exercise. Suppose that y prime is equal to 1 over the quantity 1 plus t squared, and we want to a, determine the general solution y, and b, determine the particular solution satisfying y of 1 equals 0. The solution to part a is relatively straightforward. Since we're given the derivative of y as a function of t, we can just integrate both sides to get that y is equal to the integral of 1 over the quantity of 1 plus t squared dt. And you might remember from calculus that this is an integral that comes up fairly frequently. Fortunately, we have a nice formula for it, which is arctangent of t plus c. And that's it. That is the general solution. Before we move on to part b, I just want to make a quick note, which is that in this example, the general solution is just the general antiderivative. So when you found antiderivatives in calculus, you were actually solving basic differential equations. Okay, let's go ahead and determine the solution to part b, which is equally straightforward. We just need to find the value of c that will give us a solution satisfying y of 1 equals 0. And to do that, we substitute the information into the formula for our solution. And we know that y would have to equal 0 when t is equal to 1, and that enables us to solve for c. You just have to understand that the arctangent of 1 is pi over 4, and from there we get that c is equal to negative pi over 4, and therefore y must equal arctangent of t minus pi over 4. And this is the particular solution satisfying y of 1 equals 0. All right, that's it for now, and I'll see you in the next video.